clicking on the video and watching. This video is a get to know you or get to know me video for the channel. So I hope you enjoy it. And here it goes. Ah! Just messing with you. Oof. All right. So this is the get to know you video, I guess. I seen a friend of mine, Crystal, do it the other day, and I figured it was time for something like this. So here it goes. Let's see. So don't mind me, I want to read some questions that are on that part of the screen while trying to look at the monitor and the okay. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for taking the time to watch this intro video, I guess you can call it, or getting to know you video. So here it goes. So I got a list of questions that I will read from and answer. Let's see. First one. What is your full name? Matthew Murray. What is your name? Are you named after anyone? Not particularly, no. But named after the Old Testament Matthew. Where are you from? Small little speck of dot this big called Lodi, California. So yeah, just south of Sacramento and Galt and another little small little place on the map. Where do I live now? Virginia Beach, Virginia. Yep, directly across. So if you take probably Lodi on this side and straight across, probably end up somewhere close to Virginia. Where was I born? Lodi, California. Again, a small little place on the map. Which parent are you closest to? It's my dad. Yep. What parent are you more like? My dad. What is your favorite drink? Pepsi. That's my favorite drink. What is your favorite food? Italian and Mexican food. Love that pasta. Yeah. What is your favorite holiday destination? New York City. I love the city. Gotta go there all the time. So I don't know if that's much of a holiday destination, but spent Thanksgiving there last year and had a blast in New York for Thanksgiving. So if you have the opportunity, check it out. It's definitely memorable. What is your favorite childhood memory? Well, there isn't one. There's a lot. But probably too many to mention. But growing up playing sports and running the streets and being a bad influence on people and playing basketball and for hours and hours and hours, days on days. What's your favorite pastime? Basketball. Love the sport. What is your favorite sport? Basketball and baseball, but primarily probably basketball. What's your biggest regret? Don't have any. I'm not regretful of anything I've ever done. Cause some people some trouble. You know, sometimes use these things a little too much. But yeah, not anything to be regretful about. Are you a fan of any sport teams? Yeah. So, Yankees. Sorry, don't throw anything at the screen. Don't hate me for it. New York Giants and the Los Angeles Lakers. Grew up in it as a, early 80s sports fan. Loved Magic Johnson. Grew up watching Daryl Strawberry and Dwight Gooden for the Mets. Then in the early 90s when they went to the Yankees, I followed them because that's what I did. I liked my two guys and been a Yankee fan ever since. So that's how that happened. And the Giants, that happened because I was sitting at a friend's house and the whole house was rooting for the Niners. It was a Niners or Giants game some Sunday in the mid-80s. And my favorite color, which is one of the questions down below, I think, is what's my favorite color? Blue. So literally, I'm sitting on the floor next to the couch, getting ready to, we're all getting situated for the game. And I just said, I'm going to go for the blue team. And it's been the Giants ever since. So that's how it happened. Are you a cat or dog person? Both. I don't have any preference. I don't have any animals in it right now, but have had cats and dogs growing up. Are you scared of heights? Hell yes. I say it, I'm scared of heights. I'm not gonna lie to you. One of the things, like, I go to or like New York or Chicago, and you see the people building that, like the Empire State Building, and those things, and they're on these beams sitting there having lunch overlooking the whole city. Like, you guys are nuts, man. No, I'm good. I like my feet on the ground. And then I think Chicago, which used to be called Sears Tower, is called something else now, but they have those little pop-out things that you can stand on, and look out the edge and have your picture taken, overlooking or looking on top of the city. And that's a little scary, standing on that on that glass. I mean, it's yay thick. I don't know how thick it is, but it's pretty thick. But standing on that thing, oh, that took me a minute to try to get over standing on that. It's a little tough. What's top of my bucket list? Top of my bucket list is finally going overseas somewhere, traveling outside the U.S. Never been outside the U.S. I like U.S. soil way too much, but finally going somewhere outside. What was the first movie you ever remember seeing in theaters? First movie I ever remember seeing in theaters, E.T. I think that was 81, 82. That's the first one I ever remember seeing. Do you have any pets? No pets. Like I said, no pets, no animals, no cats, no dogs, no fish, no birds, nothing like that. Been thinking about getting a dog, but that's like having a kid. It takes a lot of energy and stuff and maintenance, and it's a lot. Not to say our kids ain't bad. Kids are good, but I don't know if I can want to go back to that kind of 24-hour-a-day worry, care, that kind of stuff. What is your first pet name? So this one is so I'm sitting in the truck. My grandfather was driving. My dad was in the passenger seat. My grandpa's truck. We're driving, and it's raining. I can still see it's raining. There's a dog in the middle of the street. My dad gets out and goes, picks up the dog, brings it back, sits on my lap. I stop petting. It's all wet. But that was my first dog. Well, grandpa's dog, my dog, whichever. I kind of claimed it. But his name was Soxie, and the reason his name was Soxie is because all four of his paws were white. He had white hair around all four paws. And he had a little white patch right on the back of his neck, right behind his neck. But yeah, his name was Soxie. That was my dog. What is your biggest accomplishment? Being a great dad and the best son I could be. No other way to put it. What color are your eyes? Blue. What are your favorite color? Blue. What is your favorite ice cream? Mint chip and chocolate chip from 31 flavors, or Baskin Robbins. I think that is the best. I think they also have those ice cream shops at Rite Aid, something like that. But yeah, those are the only two kinds of ice cream I eat, if I do eat them. What's your favorite music? Everything. Except like heavy metal, headbanger stuff, that kind of stuff I don't do. But R&B, hip hop, country, a little bit of alternative. What is the most commonly swear word I use? Probably shit. Not in a negative way, but holy shit. Or shit, that just happened? I guess that's the biggest one. Do you have any tattoos? I do. I have one tattoo on the back of my left leg, and I'll put a picture of it up there somewhere. Right there. There. Yeah, I'll put a picture up right there. But that's the picture of the cross and my dad's name, dad, and the day he passed away in 2007. That's the only tattoo I got. Eventually, I'm thinking about getting my left sleeve done, probably half sleeve first and then the rest. But kicking around that idea for a little bit. Let's see. What is the first concert I ever attended? First concert I ever attended was MC Hammer and Kid and Play in Sacramento at Oracle Arena. This is probably 99, no, 89, thereabouts. But yeah. And yeah, it was pretty fun. What is your favorite high school? What was your favorite subject in high school? Math, numbers. What was your favorite job? Or first job, sorry. What was your first job? Well, in high school, you do the work program thing. So I was a dishwasher for the local hospital. So I was the hospital dishwasher in the evenings after work, after school. What was your first plane flight? That was Sacramento to Seattle. When was the last time you got into a fist fight? Oh my goodness, it's been a long time ago. Try not to use these. That's just bad news. So don't do it. Don't do it. Not worth it. But yeah, a long time ago, probably 97 thereabouts. Yeah, so what's that, 20 years ago? But yeah, it didn't work out too well for the other guy. He left a little bruised and a little bloody. But yeah, long time ago. Who has left the most impact on your life? My dad and my daughter, the two biggest influences of my life. My sister as well, both of my sisters. Who's your best teacher I ever had? Well, I had two really good teachers, middle school and high school. Middle school was my math teacher, Mr. Q, Mr. Kwasnik. He was the coolest teacher on the campus. And then in high school, we had Mr. Fujihara. Everybody just called him Fuj. Fuj was pretty cool. He was a student's teacher. So the next two questions: who is the person you call if something exciting happens, and who is the person you call if something horrible happens? Well, that's my daughter. Yep. Who is your role model? Family. Who is your celebrity crush? I don't think I have one really, but if I pick one, I'd say Holly Berry. And just because her skin is just so perfect. Who's your favorite actor? Favorite actor is Denzel Washington. Have I ever suffered a fracture? I don't know if it was fracture or dislocation. It's the only thing I ever suffered. Playing soccer at the school by the house as I was growing up, me and my three brothers. Little brother has the ball, and I go running, and I slide to kick the ball away from him, and here come my two older brothers, and bam! Pop my knee right out of place. So I have one of those long knee braces, leg strap things on for what seemed like 2 2.5 months. Long time, but yeah, it's the only medical thing of significance that happened to me. Have you ever visited a country other than outside of the US? Nope. It's on my bucket list, but I have not. Again, gotta get over the. I just like US soil way too much. If you were to give your younger self some advice, what would it be? Life is expensive. Rate your fashion sense. 5. I have some people that are really good at that, and sometimes they help me out with some of my stuff and what to wear, what not to wear, and what to stop wearing. Your driving skills, 10. I'm pretty darn good at driving. If you would ask my dad, he would say I'd probably be a race car driver in my prior life, or my next life, either one. But 10. Cooking skills. I really, for the last several years or 10 years or so, been cooking for myself, so I don't have much to gauge it on. But 4, 5-ish. I like to get better, but cooking for one doesn't necessarily, transition into excellent cooking skills. Maybe it does, but not for me. One thing you wish you knew as a kid. Again, life is expensive. Decisions can be expensive, and to do things that are effective, profitable, and understand the power of money and the decisions you make are key. Let's see here. What's the first app you check when you wake up? I don't really have an app that I go to all the time. Lately, in the last probably a month or so, it's been YouTube, to check, how many views and how many subscribers, things like that. So it's exciting to see those numbers go up, hopefully, a lot more. What's the app I use the most? Probably YouTube now. I use it a lot before, but not quite as much as I do today. What are some of my bad habits? My bad habits. Pepsi. I gotta cut that out. But Pepsi is probably my bad habit. What are your hobbies? So I'm probably going to start playing, or at least attempting to play or learn how to play the guitar. So that's going to be one of my hobbies. My YouTube channel is one of my hobbies. It's fairly, exciting to do. So one of the things that's I've always been is more of a private person and not put stuff out there too much, but keep some of that stuff, personal and close. But watching the other YouTube channels and watching my daughter's channel, and I'll put something up there for her so you guys can, again, I'm looking at the screen, but I don't know which one's important. I'll put a link to her channel, and just watching her and getting excited about that. And, I think one of the good things about YouTube is hopefully it's around forever and ever and ever and years, many years to come. And I think putting out videos that are interesting and have some content to it that people might enjoy, and maybe someday kids and grandkids and great-grandkids can go back and say, that's my grandpa or that's my great-grandpa or whatever it may be. But I think that's exciting to leave a footprint like that for the generations to come. So I think that is pretty much it. I can't think of much of anything else. Oh, there are a few other things. So, like I said, I grew up in Lodi. Siblings, I have 2 older brothers, 1 younger brother, and 2 younger twin sisters. We all grew up in a small little town. My second oldest brother is still there. Everybody else is done. Taken off throughout the country in different places now. And so go Yankees, go Giants. Giants. And then my Yankee beanie. And then that looks ridiculous. And then my Yankee mugs. Go Yankees. See that? Yep. And then my driving gloves. Sometimes I don't really wear these, but they could be driving gloves. But yeah, Giants, Yankees, Lakers. Yeah, so this is my intro video. Get to know me if you know. Comment, subscribe, all that wonderful stuff. Wherever those buttons show up, I'm not sure where they're gonna be. But yeah, so all right, thanks everyone. Bye.